When did Israel stand up as a nation? Well, that date is March 10th, 1949. But what happened prior to that? Prior to that, they stood up and declared themselves a nation on May the 14th, 1948. But they had a provisional government, to temporary cabinet, temporary government. It wasn't official yet. It was just temporary. When they first stood up as a government, their first government was March 10th, 1949. And we kind of talked about this in several prior videos. And when I was on a different channel about several months ago, we did some teachings on this. And I just want to show everybody that although Israel declared themselves as Israel on this date, they were under a provisional government. They didn't stand up as a nation officially until March 10th, 1949 with their very first government, okay? And so where does that take us to? Well, I'm going to show you on our timeline. I made a new timeline with just a couple small differences, and you're going to see them. Watch this. This was the prior timeline we had. Remember the 40-month countdown from the Revelation 12 sign to the Daniel 9 prophecy of when Jerusalem completed their 70 years, right? And I said there was something missing. There was something missing in here that we needed to find and add. And once we found it and added it, it would bring total clarity to where we are in this timeline. And when I show you this next screen and I start going through it with you, you're going to jump for joy because something's going to pop out at you and I'm going to show it to you. You ready for this? 40-month countdown right here to this date. Something was missing and we found it. We found what was missing from this date. Here it comes. There was 70 days missing. And I'm going to prove to you why there needs to be 70 days between the evening of January 23rd and January 24th, straight to Resurrection Sunday. You see, brothers and sisters, nothing's changed. Nothing's changed on this side of the equation that we had. Nothing's changed over here. This was the one thing, this 70 days. And I'm going to show you exactly in Scripture where this 70 days was hiding. And it's so clear. You're going to love this. But watch this other phenomenal thing. Watch this other phenomenal thing. Here comes another bomb. You ready? Here comes. When did we say Israel started as a nation? March 10th, 1949. March 10th, 1949. And when did they complete 70 years? You can say 70 years plus 1949 is March 10th, 2019, but that's the beginning of their 70 years. When did they complete 70 years? They completed 70 years on March 10th, 2020, 70 years was completed. But what else was special about this day? What was special about March 10th, 2020? When you start from January 1st and count to March 10th, 2020, it's 70 days. 70 years on the 70th day of the year, March 10th, 2020. That's not a coincidence, brothers and sisters. Israel completed their 70 years on March 10th, 2020. 70 years were completed. And also March 10th, 2020 is the 70th day of the year. It's a precise count of 70 years on the 70th day. And I looked at that and I said, if Israel had their 70 years and 70 days, could it be a possibility of that's what was missing for Jerusalem in the prophecy of Daniel 9 that we just went over? If Israel has their 70 years and 70th day, could Jerusalem have needed a count of their 70 years and 70 days? When does Jerusalem complete their 70 years? We've been teaching this from day one. Our very first video from 2.5 months ago proves that Jerusalem completes their 70 years on January 23rd, 2021. And when you now add 70 days to Jerusalem's count, Just like Israel's 70 days, that 70-day count brings you to precisely Resurrection Sunday, April 4th, 2021. Drop the mic. Oh, it gets better. Oh, it gets better. Brothers and sisters, believe me, this is just the beginning. Watch how everything else plays out. But first, let me show you all something. When you count 40 days from April 4th, 2021, Resurrection Sunday, which is also what? Passover Sunday. And you count 40 days. Remember the 40 days we talked about? Our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach will be here on earth visiting and giving great warning. When you count 40 days, it ends on May 14th, another anniversary date. This date, brothers and sisters, is Jerusalem's anniversary day of 70 years, 70 days. And when you count 40 more days for when Yahshua HaMashiach will be here on the earth, it lands on Israel's anniversary of May 14th. And isn't that what we just showed everyone? May 14th was what? The date in which they declared themselves a nation state. The date Israel declared themselves a nation state on May the 14th is exactly 40 days from Jerusalem's anniversary of 70 years and 70 days, the 40 days in which we've shown in many videos that our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach will be here for 40 days for his visitation, lands on the anniversary of Israel when they declared themselves a nation state. Brothers and sisters, we're just building. I'm just giving you some background to some more things that are just building and building and building right now. Let's get into one of the first things. Let's get into this visitation. We've showed this in other videos, but for all brothers and sisters who are new, I want to show this to you. So this might be a review for some, but how do we know this is Christ's visitation on earth? Because he told us. Watch, I'm going to show you. Let's go to Luke 11:30. Let's start with that. Okay. And we're going to move down here. Luke 11:30. And this is our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach talking. He says, "For as Jonas was a sign unto the Ninevites, so shall also the Son of Man be to this generation." Jonas was a warning and a sign to the Ninevites for how long? 40 days. Jonas was a sign to the Ninevites for 40 days, and he's saying himself that he himself, the Son of Man, shall also the Son of Man be to this generation, the generation we're in now. This is the generation he's talking about. He's telling us he's going to be a sign for 40 days as Jonas was. And what other verse did we find this in? Let's go to Luke 17:26. And again, this is our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach speaking. "And as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it also be in the days of the Son of Man." How many days were there in the days of Noah? How long was the flood? We all know this. 40 days. There's the 40 days again, brothers and sisters. And our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach is telling us those days. Once again in Scripture, it's a 40-day count. We just saw the 40 days he was referring to for Jonas. Now he's again referring to 40 days as Noah. 40 days. Well, how do we know it's his visitation? Well, he just told us. "So shall it also be in the days of the Son of Man." So shall it also be in the days of the Son of Man. Do we have any more proof? Can I show you again? Here we go. Let's prove it. Let's prove where our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach emphatically tells us it's the visitation date. Let's show it. Here it is. "And when our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach came near, he beheld the city, Jerusalem, and wept over it." He's weeping over it. And he says, "If thou hadst known, even thou, at least in this thy day, in this day, the things that which belong to thy peace, but now they are hid from thine eyes. For the days shall come upon thee. The days shall come upon you. It's a future prophecy. The days shall come upon thee that thine enemies shall cast a trench about thee, encompass thee round about, and keep thee in every side, and shall lay thee even with the ground. This is the destruction of Jerusalem he's talking about, and possibly other cities in Israel. And thy children within thee, and they shall not leave thee one stone upon another, because what? Because thou knewest not the time of thy visitation. Because you did not know the time of your visitation. The words of our Savior, Lord and Savior HaMashiach, has told us, has told the word, whole world. They will be laid even to the ground. Their enemies shall cast trenches about them and lay them even to the ground, because they did not know the time of their visitation. 40 days. He told us in Luke 11:30 of Jonas, 40 days. He told us in Luke 17:26, the days of Noah, 40 days. He's telling us in Luke 19:44, the Jerusalem gets laid even to the ground because they did not know the days of their visitation. And those 40 days, brothers and sisters, begins precisely. And we've just shown you, it begins precisely on April the 4th, 2021, Resurrection Sunday, the same date in 33 AD of the first Resurrection Sunday. That date is now playing out again. Passover Sunday immediately becomes Resurrection Sunday one more time, just like it did 2,000 years ago on April 4th, 2021. And 40 days, as our Lord and Savior told us, he would come to visit. And Jerusalem will be laid even to the ground. The 40 days come and go, and it ends on the anniversary of Israel. Do you see that, brothers and sisters? Do you see that? And as I've shown you before, and we're going to get back to this, when you count from the Revelation 12 sign, 1260 days, and I'm going to show you in just a little bit what this date is, why this date is so important of the 1260, but I want you to see something else. When I started laying this out, I caught something else that happened. This is the 1260 from the Revelation 12 sign, and I'm going to show you later on what this 1260 represents, but for now, we'll put that aside, and I'm going to show you something else. When you come from the Revelation 12 sign, 1290 days, you got it. Resurrection Sunday, precisely on April the 4th, this coming year, this year, April the 4th, 2021, Passover Sunday turns into Resurrection Sunday on April the 4th in the exact same date and exact same manner as the first Resurrection Sunday when our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach rose from the dead. 1290 days precisely to that date. And what else? From the Revelation 12 sign, now count 1335 days. As it tells us, this is found in Daniel 12, and this is also found in Daniel 12. Now you count the 1335 days, and where does it bring us to? Exactly Shavuot. The day, the exact day that God gave the Torah and the law to Israel. Do you see, brothers and sisters? The picture's starting to come clear now, isn't it? I want all of you to take a look at this. Take a look. Everything we have, the Revelation 12 sign absolutely leads a 40-month countdown to the day Jerusalem completes 70 years. 40-month countdown from the Revelation 12 sign, the day that Jerusalem completes 70 years, and when you do a precise 70-day count, it brings you to Resurrection Sunday. Because Israel had their 70 years and 70th day, and now Jerusalem has their 70 years and 70th day, it lands on this date. And 40 days later, when our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach has his visitation here on earth, as we just learned, it lands and ends on the anniversary of Israel, May 14th. And from the Revelation 12 sign, it's 1290 days now. From the Revelation 12 sign to Resurrection Sunday. as we're told in Daniel 12. And also in Daniel 12, from the Revelation 12 sign, 1,335 days brings us to the day that our Lord gave the law, the Torah, to Israel. Excuse me while I get a drink. Now I want to show you something else. Do you see all the connections, brothers and sisters? We had this from day one, this 40-month countdown. We had this 40-day visitation. We were just missing the 70 days. And the 70 days are accounted for 70 years and 70 days of Jerusalem. Can we find this in Scripture? Oh, yes, we can. And I'm going to show you where it's been hiding all these years. 40 months, 70 days, 40 days, and our Lord and Savior is gone after his 40-day visitation, after the bride of Christ escapes on Resurrection Sunday, as the dead in Christ did rise from the first time in history in 33 AD on April the 4th, when our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach rose from the dead, when he conquered death. The dead in Christ did rise the first time ever in history on that date of April the 4th, 33 AD. And brothers and sisters, I propose to all of you, history is about to repeat itself. April the 4th, 2021, Resurrection Sunday, will repeat precisely to the day what happened 2,000 years ago. Our Lord and Savior will be coming for his bride. The dead in Christ will rise. And our Lord and Savior, Yahshua HaMashiach, will be on the face of this earth, visiting for 40 days. And that time frame ends on the anniversary of Israel. Let's get back to these 70 days. Where has this been hiding? Where has this been hiding all these years? Watch this. Let's go to Genesis 15. And we're going to go to verse, I think it's up here. Yeah, okay. So what's going on in here? What's going on here is Joseph. We all know the story of Joseph. His father, Israel, Joseph's father, Israel, has passed away. And now Joseph is preparing his father's body. He's preparing Israel's body for burial. And it starts off, and Joseph fell upon his father's face and wept upon him. And wept upon him. You see it, brothers and sisters? Didn't we just read that? I'm going to get back to that in a second. Joseph fell upon his father's face. He fell upon Israel and wept upon him. Where did we just see that? Are you catching it? Are you getting the connections? What did Jesus do? When he came near, he beheld the city and wept over it. Wept over it. We've just now gone from the Old Testament to the New. Joseph wept over Israel as Yahshua HaMashiach, in a type and shadow, is now weeping over Jerusalem. He wept over it. What time are we saying our Lord and Savior wept over it during these 40 days? He wept over Israel, Jerusalem, for these 40 days. Do you see? It's right here. He wept over it because they knew it's not the time of their visitation. You see that? They knew not the time of their visitation. He was weeping over the city because they were laid even to the ground. Brothers and sisters, I want to propose this to you. If Jesus Christ is weeping over the city because they've been laid even to the ground, and he's there for the time of the visitation, Jerusalem must have been destroyed already. They must have been destroyed. The attack must have come. He is now there for 40 days, weeping over them. He's weeping over Israel. He's weeping over Jerusalem, just as who wept over Israel? Who wept over Israel? We just showed you that. Joseph. And we know Joseph, in these stories, has always been a type and shadow of our Lord and Savior, Yahshua HaMashiach. We know that. This is the Old Testament. And he's weeping over Israel, his father. He's weeping over Israel, his father. Watch this. You want to see the time frame? Here it comes. And 40 days were fulfilled for him. There it is. There it is. Bombshell. Joseph is weeping over Israel. 40 days. Joseph, our Lord and Savior Yahshua HaMashiach, is weeping over Israel and Jerusalem for 40 days. This is the 40 days. Where's the 70? Watch this. And 40 days were fulfilled for him. For so are fulfilled the days of those which are embalmed. And the Egyptians mourned for him 70 days. 70 days. The Gentiles. These aren't Jews. The strangers. The Gentiles mourned for Israel 70 days. I'll say it again. The strangers. The Gentiles mourned over Israel for 70 days. There it is. Not only is this date, 70 years and 70 days of Jerusalem completing 70 years and 70 days, which lands on Resurrection Sunday, which lands on Passover Sunday, but it's also 70 days in which the stranger, the Gentiles, mourned for Israel. Isn't that what's happened, brothers and sisters? I want everyone to think about what's happened in the last several days. When this day came and passed, a lot of us, including myself, mourned. What's happened? This was the date when Jerusalem completed the 70 years. What could it be? What else is there? There's nothing else. We didn't have any more information at that time. This day came and went. It is an accurate date. This is the date. We've shown that. This is the date where Jerusalem completed 70 years. But what happens? The stranger, the Gentiles, need to mourn for 70 days. The stranger, the Gentile, needs to mourn for 70 days for Jerusalem and Israel. Do you see? That's what we have in the scripture. The Egyptians, the strangers, mourned for 70 days. And that's exactly what's playing out here. And it's the exact 70 days from the anniversary of when Jerusalem completed 70 years. 70 days later, Jerusalem completes their 70 days, just like the Egyptians completed their 70 days. Do you see? The mourning for 70 days. And then Joseph, as a type and shadow of Jesus Christ, he mourned for 40 days. The same way Jesus Christ wept over Jerusalem because they didn't know the time of their visitation. And it ends on Israel's anniversary. Here it is, brothers. I want you, brothers and sisters, I want you all to see this. Israel's anniversary. What did we just show in scripture? Who are they mourning? Israel. Gentile and Jew alike, whether it's 40 days or 70 days, they were mourning Israel. Jew and Gentile alike. In this verse, Genesis 53, chapter 50, verse 3, Gentiles and Jews alike were mourning 40 and 70 days for Israel. Do you see it? Mourning 70 and 40 days for Israel on the anniversary of Israel. In this story, brothers and sisters, they were mourning Joseph's father, Israel. This is Joseph's father, Israel. He is the father of the land of Israel. We all know that. Israel, the man, is the father of the land, Israel. And that's what's going on. The Gentiles and the Jews are mourning over Israel, and that date lands exactly on May the 14th, 2021, this year. drop the mic.